Your nervous system houses a guidance instrument more precise than anything, emotion. Each feeling is a meter reading of electrical coherence between two streams of thought, the core desire you have already launched, and the sentence you are repeating right now. When the sentence matches the desire, circuits stay open. Blood chemistry steadies, pulse smooths, ideas arrive in orderly lines. When the sentence contradicts the desire, voltage drops and muscles tighten. There is no moral judgment in the sensation, it is raw telemetry. Learn to read it and decision-making accelerates beyond strategy or luck. Every preference you form is instantly recorded as a standing wave in what neuroscience calls the default mode network and can be called inner being. That wave becomes a live destination marker. Meanwhile, conscious thought keeps moving across scenes, headlines, and body sensations. When conscious focus drifts onto material that agrees with the destination marker, brain coherence spikes and you register pleasure, relief, or drive. When focus drifts onto contradictions, coherence falls and the body flags you with tension, fatigue, or dullness. Emotion is simply the differential between the two readings. Clarity, appreciation, eagerness, people rank these as positive states. The real definition is technical, signal-to-noise ratio is high. Attention is streaming through an unobstructed channel, so cortical regions synchronize, endocrine output stays balanced, and heart rate variability widens. In that alignment, mental images carry enough charge to influence probability. A single idea held in that condition recruits opportunities with what looks like supernatural speed. It only appears supernatural because most planning occurs in misalignment, requiring 10 extra steps to compensate for disrupted circuitry. An idle wish generates a low-amplitude destination marker. If a contradictory thought pops up, the emotional pinch is mild. Stronger desire raises amplitude. Now any contradicting thought produces a louder alarm. Emotional pain is not punishment, it is proportional feedback. High ambition demands tight focus, the way higher voltage demands thicker insulation. Understanding that ratio prevents self-criticism when negative emotion flares, it simply means the goal carries serious current. Some philosophies promote radical indifference, preferring nothing, accepting everything. That neurologically flattens amplitude. A flat line means minimal guidance, which might sound peaceful yet disables deliberate creation. The human cortex evolved for preference, evaluation, and forward projection. Deny that wiring and the organism drifts into inertia. The practical approach is selective focus, cultivate clear preferences, monitor emotional readouts, recalibrate thoughts that jam the circuit, and move. Supply at the quantum level is elastic. When one individual sharpens a preference, the informational field expands to include it. No other person's allocation shrinks. Competition becomes obsolete once the mechanics are grasped. Accepting that premise removes anxiety about someone else getting there first and frees cognitive bandwidth for alignment work, which is the only lever that ever mattered. Most people let external conditions dictate their emotional set point. Newsfeed up, mood down, bonus announced, mood up. That is passive telemetry with no steering. Deliberate creators reverse the sequence, adjust thought first, then watch conditions reconfigure. The time gap between mental adjustment and material evidence starts wide but narrows as trust builds. Mastery begins when the individual values emotional guidance over visible data. Mastery stabilizes when visible data consistently matches the earlier emotional tuning. Picture a vertical scale. Bottom reads, powerless, middle reads, neutral, top reads, free. Depression sits near the bottom, anger above it, hope above anger, clarity at the top. Each move upward signals restoration of circuitry. Climbing two rungs in a session is respectable. Attempting to leap from despair to bliss usually backfires because the frequency gap is too wide, producing cognitive dissonance. The rule is simple: reach for relief, not euphoria. Identify the dominant sentence running through your mind, rate the emotional sting, then craft a statement one notch lighter in weight. The new sentence may still carry tension, yet it eases amperage enough to reopen partial flow. Recognize the tiny relief consciously, this reinforces agency, then repeat until the body confirms further ease. Incremental climbs compound rapidly. Processes are tools, not rituals. Choose based on current altitude. If you sit near neutral but want momentum, use segment intention. Before entering a new environment, declare the emotional tone you choose to maintain for the next 15 minutes. If you feel stuck in heavy anxiety, employ a focus will on paper, place the neutral core statement in the center and write evidence of its partial truth in a circle around it until the body signals release. If you wake in mild discouragement, apply the rampage of appreciation silently for 2 minutes, listing realities that already function. Stop the instant appreciation turns mechanical, forced lists reverse progress. Alignment is a hygiene practice, comparable to dental care. Skip a day and function continues, skip a week and decay sets in. 2 5-minute check-ins, morning and late afternoon, suffice. Morning sets baseline. Afternoon prevents accumulation of minor resistances. Night review can be helpful but optional. Overanalysis before sleep sometimes reactivates friction. Long before emotion registers, the body issues microsignals, a shallow breath that won't deepen, a jaw muscle that refuses to unclench, an urge to scroll aimlessly. These are pre-vibrational alarms. Catching them early is efficient because the thought stack behind them is still light, easy to redirect. Build a habit of pausing the moment a physical glitch appears. Trace backward to identify the subject you just considered, then shift attention to a neutral topic for 60 seconds. The body will confirm resolution with a spontaneous breath release or subtle warmth behind the eyes. Offices, family dinners, online forums, all are energy lattices shaped by shared focus. Entering a tense lattice while aligned can feel like stepping into static. The reflex is to mirror the prevailing tone, but alignment offers a stronger move, act as a stabilizer. Maintain inner rhythm through deliberate breathing and soft peripheral vision, resist the instinct to announce solutions. Stable presence lowers group turbulence without debate. Evidence of success arrives when voices slow and conversation pivots to practical topics. Some environments reward urgency and suspicion. Rather than fleeing or fighting, reframe them as training grounds. Set a private challenge to hold steadiness for a defined interval, perhaps the length of a meeting, regardless of surrounding volatility. Record the outcome afterwards. With repetition, the nervous system learns to treat external intensity as mere data, conserving energy for creative thought even under tight deadlines. Overt positivity often triggers resistance in observers who are entrenched in pessimism. Stealth alignment works better. Internally note one aspect of the current scene that functions adequately: lighting, chair support, clock accuracy, then expand that internal inventory for 20 seconds. No words are spoken, yet your field brightens. People nearby frequently shift posture or breathe more deeply without knowing why. Influence requires no proclamation. Information streams are designed to spike adrenaline. Before opening a news feed, set a duration limit and a content filter anchor such as technological progress or ecological restoration. Scroll until emotional reading dips, exit immediately. This trains selective attention, proving that you control intake rather than the reverse. Over time, the algorithm mirrors your preference, reducing the need for discipline. Unplanned delays, canceled plans, harsh feedback, these disruptions can serve as alignment workouts. The mind initially labels them obstacles, triggering resistance. Recast each one as a timed experiment. How quickly can internal comfort be restored without external change? Measuring recovery speed converts irritation into a gamified metric, reinforcing mastery and reducing fear of future surprises. Morning baseline, midday reset, and situational drills create overlapping reinforcement. Consistency matters more than duration. 5 minutes of clear signal three times a day outperforms one long weekly session because neural pathways consolidate through repetition. Eventually, alignment becomes the default tone, and guidance messages reach consciousness before circumstances drift off course. Emotion is not decoration, it is instrumentation. Treat readings as navigation data, adjust thoughts to keep the pointer in the green band, and external conditions reorganize with logistical precision. The sequence is reliable: awareness, minor shift, bodily confirmation, material evidence. Practice until doubt fades and the guidance system is trusted as fully as eyesight or balance. Use these principles daily. The system is already speaking. Sustained attention is the only missing component.